The General Jackson Showboat. It's 300 feet long, four stories high, and holds 1,200 people. Hi, friends. Steve Hall along with my little buddy Shotgun Red, and we're going to take you on board the world's largest showboat for a performance of my show, Steve Hall, Shotgun Red, and the Shotgun Red Band.
There was a boy in Arkansas, wouldn't listen to his mom when she told him he should go to school. They'd sneak away in the afternoon, take a little walking, and pretty soon he'd find him at the local auction barn. Well, now he'd stand and listen carefully, then pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. He said, oh my, it's do or die, I've got to learn that auction cry, gotta be like Mark and be an auctioneer. Eight, one, a $5 bid, and now 30, a 30, a 30, make a 30 bid, I'm already at a whim, 30, who'll a bid, a $30 bid. Well, there are a lot of bid and out, 35 we aim, 35 make a 35, 35 we'll get a bit of that, $35 bid. Yeah, buddy. Well, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man, cross digits bear, man, I'm a reaching mountain air, man, drive about in my share, man, I've been everywhere. I've been a Reamer, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Silver, Dugo, Vidya, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Dab, I've been a mom, and I'm a lab, a little Angus, seven, a ram, and a ram, who's a killer, I'm a dealer, I'm a mom, a killer, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere. Cross is a bear, man, I breathe a mountain air, man, trail him out of my share, man, I've been everywhere. Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Boston, Houston, King, Sex, and a Monterey, Birdie, Santa Bada, Adams, Atlanta, Mac, Park, Regular, Babble, Tennessee, Hennessy, Chicken, Beach, Burlake, Winter, Lake, Double Lake, World, Beach, Lake,
I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere.
Boston, Houston, Bear, man, I breathe the mountain air, man, drive about in my share, man, I've been everywhere. Louisville, Asheville, London, London, Water, 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 Cash, Bit, Fink, Baker, Sheep, Dax, Sick, and Agana, Deborah, I'd hold you in a man, I pass the Gannon, see you in a meter, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere. Boston, Houston, Bear, man, I breathe the mountain air, man, drive about. Well, buddy, hold on, you don't look very excited. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking I screwed up, missed a word here and there. Well, that's not the truth. When you do a big show like the General Jackson, they don't let me use my own PA system. I don't own any A-I stuff. Some A-I-ms it doesn't work. So don't A-I system's about the best I've ever sang through. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. On the bottom, middle, third, three, make it middle, three, middle, three, middle, three, middle, middle, three, three, make it right, right, well, hop, get down there in bed. I'm getting a mountain mucking boy. Black 29 in the morning, gonna get home. I told that hawk for a $50 bed. Yes, I did. Oh, yeah. It's gonna be a good show today, I'll tell you that. Let's give the man upstairs a nice hand for a perfect day to go have some fun. What do you think of that? We just got back in Canada last year. We got any Canadians on board? Any Canadians? No. Did you have trouble coming across the Canadian border? No? Wait till you go home. Yeah. I know. We go across with the bus, and I'll tell you, they pop off the hubcaps, dig through the luggage, look up underneath stuff, and you know what I think it is? I think they've heard a bad rumor, like a lot of you people have heard, that all musicians and entertainers do drugs, and that's a lie. I've been in the business since I was 15 years old, and I'm proud to say I never once done drugs. I don't do them, and my band members don't do them. They're the best in the business. And old Giggling Jerry, our steel guitar player, he'll get you in trouble with that laugh. When you go across the Canadian border, one of them border guards jumps up on the bus and goes, hold on a second. You guys don't got any guns in here, do you? Don't let him lean out of the bunk. Why? How many you need? 3 days they locked us up at the border. Don't they serve a good meal here on the General Jackson? Don't they put on a good feed? Good food, good service, and a good thing you're eating today instead of yesterday. Yesterday was pickled beef tongue day. I know it. I can't eat nothing comes out of an animal's mouth. Pickled beef tongue.
Boy, and I can't either. What do you like, Steve?
I like eggs. See, breakfast crowds don't like that joke that much, do they?
No, they usually don't laugh that much.
Boy, I'll tell you, it's going to be a good show today. I know it for an absolute fact. I called my 1-900 psychic line just before I got on board. In fact, if someone will just yell out your astrological sign, I can tell you a little bit about yourself. Sagittarius is usually the sign of the big mouth. The first one to yell out in any group. That's a Sagittarius. We narrowed that down in a hurry, didn't we? Yeah? Let me brag on this young man right here. Not only is he a great singer, he's a great songwriter. He wrote four songs for Garth Brooks. Yeah, boy.
Thank you.
You decided when you're going to mail them to him?
Monday.
Monday. Hey, Bobby Green, come on up here a second. This is our bass guitar player, Bobby Green. He just got back off a long vacation, and he had a little trouble. Nothing serious. Show him, Bobby. Temporary brace on his left ankle. He's been dating Tanya Harding. Good thing you ain't been dating Lorena Bobbitt, ain't it? Boy, I bet he'd have cut his vacation short then, wouldn't he? His name's Bobby Green. I know that name doesn't ring a bell to a lot of you people, but how many people have heard of the song He Stopped Loving Her Today by George Jones?
Thank you very much.
That young man right over there had absolutely nothing to do with that song. That's why his name don't ring a bell to nobody. We got a young lady going to sing for you right now. She's from up in Wisconsin. Anybody here from Wisconsin? Nobody? Wisconsin stinks. Always has, always will. We like them people. We don't sell them tickets. We don't want them in here. No, Wisconsin's a great state. Had a little trouble up there, too. We played in Green Bay. Had a pretty good time. She's from Louisville.
No, we never had a pretty good time in Green Bay. We had a great time. In fact, they invited us back next year to the Green Bay Winter Carnival. So if you folks happen to be in Green Bay...
Hold on a second. Before we go promoting any bookings, I don't know anything about a Green Bay Winter Carnival. Who booked that?
Same guy that booked us last year.
Same guy?
I walked right up on stage after.
Yeah, he came up at the end and he didn't say nothing about it. You're not talking about Frank. Frank didn't say Winter Carnival. That's not what Frank said. He said it'll be a cold day when you guys play here.
Well, it was a cold day when we played there last time, too.
I never met so many pickpockets in one town as I met in Green Bay, Wisconsin. I got so mad I just cut the pockets right out of my pants. Yeah, they reach in there now to get a surprise, I'll tell you. Because I reach through from the other side and shake hands with them. Yeah. Oh, I know what you're thinking. She's from Crivitz, Wisconsin. Give a warm round of applause to Cheryl Lynn. Here's Cheryl.
Who's there? Have your boots been under? Well, whose bed have your boots been under? Whose heart did you steal, I wonder? This time did it feel like thunder, baby? But whose bed have your boots been under? Don't look so lonely, don't act so blue. I know I'm not the only girl you run to. I know about Lolita, you live in Spanish Flame. I seen you around with Rita, the redhead down the lane. Well, whose bed have your boots been under? Whose heart did you steal, I wonder? This time did it feel like thunder, baby? Have you been kissing? Whose ear did you make a wish in? Is she the one that you've been missing, baby? Well, whose bed have your boots been under? I heard you've been sneaking around with Jill. And what about that weekend with Beverly Hills? And I've seen you walking with Long Legs Louise. You weren't just talking last night with Denise. Well, whose bed have your boots been under? Whose heart did you steal, I wonder? This time did it feel like thunder, baby? Have you been kissing? Whose ear did you make a wish in? Is she the one that you've been missing, baby? Well, whose bed have your boots been under? Play that steel guitar. Baby, she'll will be free.
Do, 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 do.
But whose bed have your boots been under? Whose heart did you steal, I wonder? This time did it feel like thunder? Whose bed have your boots been under? Whose heart did you steal, I wonder? This time did it feel like thunder? She the one that you've been missing, baby. But who's been, have your boots been under?
Who's been,
have your boots been under? I don't know.
Who's been,
have your boots been
baby
under?
Who's been,
have your boots been
oh,
under?
Oh, baby.
Who's been,
have
your boots been under? Well, who's been, have your boots been under?
Thank you.
Cheryl Lynn from up in Wisconsin. What a talent. Hey, did you take a picture of me yet? The girl in the green, did you take a picture of me? Take another picture of me. Get your camera on. Turn on. No, stand up so it don't look like you're looking up our nose hairs or something. Hold on. Hold on a second. We'll do a band photo. Band photo. Get in the middle. What brand is that camera? You don't know? Let me sweetheart, recognize this? You don't? That's because it's my watch. That's why you don't recognize it. Them women don't know what they buy anymore, you know? Does your wife shop a lot?
Sure does.
Boy, my wife holds a black belt in shopping. You think I'm lying? Somebody stole her American Express card. I just got the bill. I ain't turning the guy in. He spends less than she does, you know? You guys were here last week, weren't you?
No.
In them same two chairs?
Yeah,
are you sure? I recognize this couple. In fact, I remember the lady went to the bar, got her a bottle of something. I ain't saying what she was drinking, but the more she drank, the shorter she got. She was shrinking and shrinking. Her little feet shot out. And she just slid right under the table. I said, sir, I don't want to say your wife's had too much to drink, but I think your wife just slid under the table. He said, no, I think my wife just walked in the front door. So I don't know. Maybe that ain't even the guy. Where are you guys from?
California.
California. I thought you guys all slid in the ocean here a few years back. How long have you been married? 48 years. Couple married 50 years, sitting on the front porch. One night she poked him in the ribs and said, hey, have you thought about our sexual relations lately? He said, you know, I have, and we didn't even get a Christmas card from him last year. Are you staying over at the Opryland Hotel? Because that's a beautiful hotel over there, I'll tell you. But don't call down the front desk and ask for nothing, because sometimes it won't help you. The other night, me and Miss Daisy got us a room over there just to spend an evening alone. I called down the front desk. I said, the room is sharp. Everything looks great, but I got a leak in my sink. And the guy said, go ahead, and hung up. So I don't know what to do. Daisy said, maybe this room is bugged, you know, like that Watergate Hotel. I said, I don't know. I'll check. I looked under curtains, behind lampshades, under ashtrays, and I noticed there was a rug laying on the floor that didn't match nothing, so I peeled it back. Sure enough, there was a round plate, had a big bolt on top of it. I took that bolt off, looked under that plate. There wasn't anything. So I covered it back up. We went to check out the next morning. The guy says, how'd you sleep last night? I said, good. Why? He said, did you hear what happened to the couple in the room below you? I said, what? He said, a chandelier fell right on top of them people. We got a young lady going to entertain you right now that she's going to be one of the superstars of the future. I know it because she's my granddaughter. And if you would, welcome her out to the stage. Here's little Megan May. Give her a nice hand, Meg.
In case I forgot to mention, Grandpa's girl is only 7 years old, so this would be her first video.
Lie beside me on the sand and put some motion in your hand. Come on and make me feel nice. Kiss me once or twice. Say you love me again. Roll rub it in, rub it in.
Rub it in, rub it in.
I feel the tango begin to get under my skin.
Rub it in, rub it in.
Turn the radio on and find the slow grooving song. Whisper in your ear, say the things I want to hear. Let me know your love is strong.
Rub it in, rub it in. Rub it in, rub it in.
I feel the tango begin to get under my skin.
Rub it in, rub it in.
Rub it in,
rub it in.
I feel the tango begin to get under my skin.
Rub it in, rub it in.
I feel the tango begin to get under my skin.
Rub it in, rub it in.
Sweetheart, I did want to tell him one thing, that we share a couple things in common. We both love country music, and we're both scared to death of her grandmother. Who happens to be over here with our other little granddaughter, Kayla. Come on out here, Meg. Come here a second, Meg. Kayla, come here. I want to introduce the family real quick. Say hi to this whole bunch for me. Wait, this is my wife, Daisy. Throw a kiss, Kaybird. And little Meg. Thanks a lot, you guys. Give them a nice hand. Little girl coming out here singing, stealing the show. Don't you ever come out here again. Got any grandparents in here? Grandparents? Oh, boy, I bet you got them pictures of them grandkids with you, ain't you? I'll tell you, there's something else. Megan, when she was only about a year old, Daisy said, you want to watch Megan? I said, sure, what do I do? He said, it's easy. As soon as she wakes up, change her and give her a bottle. I said, I can do that. Daisy calls me at 5 o'clock in the afternoon and says, how's Megan? I said, I'm not going to say our little granddaughter's spoiled, but she smells that way, you know? She said, you change her? I said, first thing this morning, I changed her and gave her a bottle. She said, how about since? I said, since what? She said, since this morning. Did you change her since this morning? I said, you didn't tell me to do that. And I read the instructions. It says, right on the front of that Pampers box, get up to 8 pounds. Doesn't it? Doesn't it? Doesn't it? I was going to use the one marked Huggies. That said, good to 24 pounds on there. We got a song here, features everybody in the band. Let's them show off a little bit. Got a visit from our little buddy, Shotgun Red. We got any TNN watchers in here? TNN watchers? How about hee-haw watchers? Any hee-haw watchers?
Okay, how many weight watchers do we have? Raise your hand if you're a weight watcher.
Well, little Shotgun Red will be out in a minute. We brought some other stars we know you'll enjoy. One, two, one. Don't care, Mom. No lie, gonna do that. George Jones. Here's a living legend, George Jones.
I struggling hard today. All I place dream upon this door. Hearts in the carry them away. I struggling hard.
Don't care, Mom, no lie, gonna do that Johnny Cash. Mom, no lie, no Johnny Cash. All right.
Looks like he needs to be worm, doesn't it?
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash, and here's a big hit song I had back in the 60s. Go like this right here. This is it. You shut up over there. Can't remember the first couple of words there. Well, what's the second verse after that? Where you been, buddy? Could you hear us in there? Good, because we could hear you out here. Good. Good. That's what Campbell's soups are. Good. Sewage. Hold on a second. Anybody in here from Texas? Welcome, United States. Good to have you up here with us. There's a Texan, Willie Nelson.
In the twilight, low I see her. Blue eyes cry in the rain. Meet again. And someday when we meet up down there, we'll stroll hand in hand again. Land that knows no parting. Blue eyes crying in the rain. All right, thank you very much. 1-800-4-WAVE.
All right, thank you very much.
Got any Merle Haggard fans in here? Merle Haggard? I wish we knew some of his songs. Actually, this crazy guy over here joined the band when he was only 16 years old. I remember that night quite well. He come walking into this beer nightclub we were working. Said he could pick and sing. I said, can you sing country music? He said, I can do Merle Haggard better than Merle Haggard.
Yeah, Merle. Hey, I'm tired of this dirty old city. And I'm tired of too much work. Lord, never enough late.
He also told me he could do Bo Cephas, Hank Williams Jr.
Are you ready for some real food?
Hardee's. I love the commercial where he goes, are you ready for some real food? Hardee's. And then they go off in the, sorry about that.
Don't ask me, Hank, why do you drink? Hank, why do you roll some more? Why must you live out the songs you roll?
He said for all them girls, he does Dwight Yoakam.
Thank you very much. I ain't getting in wasting just can't tear me. My face on the ground.
Hold on a second, hold on. I've been working on one. I love you, you love me. We're a you're a sick crowd, you know that? Some of them people were singing along with that, you know? Barney's song. Don't you know who's in that big purple suit? Pee-wee Herman's in there. Here's a guy I really miss, Ernest Tubb in the Texas Troubadours. E.T.
I'm walking the floor over you. I can't sleep a wink, that is true. I'm hoping and I'm praying as my heart breaks right in two. I'm walking the floor over you.
by Cracky.
I've been in the business 20 years, never heard nobody ever do Frankie Valli from the Four Seasons till I heard this guy. If you can sing that high, let's hear you do Vince Gill.
Who cared us after all these years together? Who cared us after all?
Music. Here's the tall guy with the hat, Jackson.
Woo! Gonna make a change.
Chasing that neon rainbow, I'm living that honky tonk dream. It's all I've ever wanted. Is to pick this guitar and sing.
Here's Freddie Fender, Freddie.
Wasted days and wasted nights. I have left buggy behind. And why should I go on when you're the blame?
Oh, the legendary Jim Reeves.
Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone.
The number one selling song of all time.
If you're traveling the interstates of this country and looking for a place to stay, go to Motel 6. Around 25 bucks, a little more in some places, a little less in others, you get a clean, comfortable room. No, we don't give you free tickets to ride the Hangman at Opryland, but you get what you need. For reservations, just call any of our 750 locations at our new number, 1-800-4-MOTEL-6. Well, I'm Tom Bidette from Motel 6. Happy hanging, and we'll leave the light on for you.
Michael Jackson's ex-father-in-law.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart?
What do you think of the band? Aren't they terrific? Aren't they great? You know, this is a regular band up here with me today. Some of these people have been with me since Monday. Well, it's tough to keep a group together for a long time. It's tough to keep a group.
Yeah.
people won't be with me Monday. This guy's actually been with me almost 20 years. His name's Mark. You can applaud him if you'd like. Marcus. 20 years ago, he joined the band. He said, there's nothing I wouldn't do for you. I told him the same thing. I said, there's nothing I wouldn't do for you either. And for 20 years, we haven't done nothing for each other. This guy over here had been with us 8 years. 8 years ago, Roger did an audition for me that knocked us right out. He did 55 different impressions of country artists, rock artists, pop artists, radio personalities. I found out at the audition that he had been blind since birth. He taught himself how to play a guitar. He taught himself how to sing and taught himself how to do impressions. He ain't handicapped. He's blessed. What a talent.
Thank you very much.
That's enough. He's also a troublemaker. You think I'm lying? He rides to work with me. We'll pull up to a stop sign. He looks out his window and says, go ahead. It's good my way.
Yeah, well, I was just seeing if he was paying attention.
Yeah, I was paying attention. Walked in the music store, grabbed his C&I dog by the tail, picked him up, started swinging him around over his head. Guy said, gonna help? He said, nah, we're just looking around. He said, we're just looking around. You got your hearing aid turned up over there, buddy? You know, there was a guy in here yesterday bragging about his new hearing aid. He said it was one of them brand new hard-to-see Supertronic models, the best that money could buy. I said, really, what kind is it? He said, it's a little after nine, I think, I don't know. I said, let me see that thing. Pulled out of his ear, it was a suppository stuck in there, you believe that? I thought he'd be mad. He started laughing, told his wife, you can quit looking for the hearing aid now, I guess. I said, Roger, what do you like to do on your day off? He said, lots of stuff. I go swimming, dancing, chase girls. Of course, he uses the Braille method. He said, it's good enough for Clinton. It's good enough for him. That's what he said. Oh, I ain't gonna pick on poor Bill Clinton, say he's got this country screwed up, but I heard there's people sneaking back into Mexico. Does that tell you something? Shouldn't pick on Clinton. Somebody whipped a beer bottle at him yesterday during a press conference. Did you hear about this? Oh, he's okay. It was a draft. He dodged it. Yeah! See, some people don't like that joke, but I got to remind you, because of the veterans, men and women that are sitting in this room this very second, that served alongside of the men and women that will not be in this room today or tomorrow or any other day. Collectively, they gave you so much freedom. Remember, when you get in your car, you can go anywhere you want, anytime you want. You can live where you want. You can dress how you want. You can say what you want. And you can thank one group and one group only for that freedom. Some of them are here today, the veterans. God bless you and welcome aboard. My heart is with you. I'll tell you, I had a lady in here yesterday. She was pretty mad at me. You better shut up. Quit picking on Bill Clinton. We're from Arkansas. I said, no, wait a minute. We're just comedians having a little fun, telling a few jokes, because Americans love to laugh. She said, I don't care. We're building a highway in Arkansas called the Bill Clinton Highway, just in his honor. Did you know that? I said, I didn't know that. Is it crooked and slick? Got a big yellow streak running up the... Oh, you like that joke, huh? I got another one for you. New Bill Clinton stamp coming out. Two-faced don't stick to nothing. I said, Roger, what's the scariest thing you ever did? He said, well, I went skydiving. I said, is that scary? He said, you ought to hear my dog whine on the way down. I said, how do you know when your feet are going to hit the ground? He said, you'll know. The leash will go limp. Hey! Y'all having a good time so far? Everybody having a good time? I welcome my friends from out in California. Good to have you on board, I'll tell you what. Aren't children something? I referred to that because I heard a story the other day that I thought was terrific. I think we should trust children more than we do, because there was this first grade class down at the local police station. They were on their field trip. And the police chief says, here's where we keep records of all the criminals. Over here's where we keep the cells, where we keep the criminals. And these pictures up here are pictures of America's most wanted. And a little girl in first grade actually asked this question. She said, are those really pictures of America's most wanted criminals? You want to catch them and put them in your jail? He said, that's right. She said, how come you didn't keep them here when you took their picture? Wouldn't you love to hear the answer to that question, huh? I'll go grab my little buddy Shockin' Red and bring him out here. And while we do that, here's Roger to do Marty Robbins. Take it away, Mark.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, yeah. I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Cradled by two loving arms that I'm dying for,
one little kiss and Felina goodbye.
Roger Francis, ladies and gentlemen, right there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, folks. And right now, while Steve and Shotgun Red are backstage talking, I'd like to tell each and every one of you that we try to do something religious during every show that we do here on the boat. So right now, I'd like to take up a collection. It's a little wild, man, from the Nashville Network, Shotgun Red!
I'm sorry it took so long for Red to get out here. As you folks know that see him on TNN, he's shy. What are you doing?
I'm cruising chicks, man. They make my heart go bumpity-bumpity. What's got four arms and loves girls?
What?
Me and you. Got pretty girls over here, got pretty girls over there, got pretty girls in the front, in the back. Uh-oh, stop the music, stop the music.
What is it?
I can't believe it. There's Dolly Parton sitting right back there.
Where's she at?
Way in the back. No, that's two bald-headed guys sitting side by side.
Introduce the guys in the band. Can you do that?
On the bass guitar on the far end over there, he's from Nashville, Tennessee. Let's hear for Bobby Green on the bass. Yeah, Bobby. On the lead guitar, he's from Nisswa, Minnesota. We call him the Cadillac Kid, Mark Peterson. Let's hear for Marcus. Yeah, Mark. Back on the drums from Chicago, Illinois, playing them Ludwig drums. He's a fabulous drummer. Let's hear for Vince D. Yeah, Vincent. Over on the steel guitar, look at the hairdo on that one. Man, oh man, oh man. You've been watching that Lion King movie again, ain't ya? He's from up in Lexington, Kentucky, the great steel player Jerry Taylor. Let's hear it for JT. Yeah, Jerry. Step right up, young lady. She's all the way from... Man, look at them britches. I'll bet she put them on with an air compressor. I bet you could put a dime in the hip pocket and read the date. What are you laughing at, Jerry Taylor?
1987!
It is! She's from Crivets, Wisconsin. Let's hear for Cheryl Lynn. Yeah, that's Cheryl. Straight ahead, Roger. 40 feet. Keep walking. You're doing good. Just straight ahead. I don't like him.
Why not?
Don't he drive the bus?
Red, that's impossible.
No, it ain't. He used to drive bus for George Jones. That's why they never showed up. He's from Pequot Lakes, Minnesota. Roger the Dodger Francis. Let's hear it for Roger Dodger.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Shut up, Jerry. You drive a Ford. F-O-R-D. Flimsy old rebuilt Dodge. Found on road dead. Fixed or repaired daily. Flip it over and read directions. You know, Ford backwards as driver returns on foot.
Explain to these people what you're talking about.
All them cars in the parking lot, the letters across the hood, they stand for something.
You mean like Pinto?
Put in new transmission often.
All right, how about Dodge?
Demo dudes go everywhere.
Even that little Italian car, Fiat?
Fix it again, Tony.
About GMC.
Got a mechanic coming.
About AMC.
Ain't my car.
All right, Subaru.
Subaru, just read it backwards. You are a bus.
Chevrolet.
Cracked heads, every valve rattles, oil leaks, exhaust tubes.
Here's one for you, Toyota.
Too often Yankee overpriced this auto.
All right, one more. How about Pontiac?
Poor old New Yorker thinks it's a Cadillac. Poor old New Yorker thinks it's a Cadillac. Not paying attention.
I don't know. What are you doing?
Hey, look at this. My butt looks like an elbow. Get tennis butt. Hey, look, buddy, I found a hearing aid. You ever take a bath?
Yes, get up here, would you? Get up here. What's the matter?
Kind of sad.
Why can you be sad? It's a terrific crowd. Everybody's having a good time.
What about my dogs?
What's the matter with your dogs?
They're dead.
Your dogs are dead?
3 days ago, the garbage man backed right over both of our little dogs.
I'm sorry to hear that. Did you tell Miss Daisy?
No, I'm scared. I just called up a taxidermist.
What's he laughing at?
He knows the punchline. Don't you?
He called up a taxidermist.
Yeah, the guy said, sorry about them dogs. You want them mounted? I said, no. Just have them shaking hands or something. Some of them get it, some of them don't. We used to farm. We used to raise apples and wild hickory nuts. We used to store them in our basement. Had a big pile of apples over here. Had a great big pile of hickory nuts over there. You know, something got to eating on them things, so I put a trap over by the apples. I put another trap over by the nuts. Next day, I caught a rat this big. I said, Mom, look at the big rat I caught. She said, wow, did you catch him by the apples? I said, no, Ma. Shut up and let me finish. I said, no, Ma, we caught him by the tail. I'm telling them clean, they must be thinking dirty or something. Uncle Herman just went down, signed up for Social Security. His wife said, you better take along your birth certificate. You'll need that. He said, I'll bet I don't. He went down there. They signed him right up. His wife said, how'd you get him to sign you up? He said, it was easy. When that young lady asked me how old I was, I opened up my shirt, showed her the gray hair on my chest. She signed me up. His wife said, you better drop your trousers. We could have got disability.
So you need to explain that.
He's got bad knees. His knees have always been bad. Walked in the doctor's office. Out come an 85-year-old woman running and screaming. Bah! Flew out the front door. I said, Doc, you ain't touching me. Do you tell me what you did to her? He said, I didn't do nothing to her. I just told her she was going to have a baby. She's going to have a baby? He said, no. But it cured her of her hiccups. Don't you know she run down to the nearest telephone booth, called up her husband, 90 years old, said, Henry, you old coot, you got me pregnant. He said, who is this? He said, who is this?
You better quit picking on that guy. He's bigger than you.
He can't kick my butt. I ain't even got one.
Did y'all enjoy the cruise with us so far today? Did everybody have a good time? Y'all enjoy yourself.
Tell about the goodies?
We're just about out of time. We'll tell you, we're carrying souvenirs like all groups. Every now and then, we got the world-famous little Shotgun Red dolls that you've seen on the Nashville Network, and they're guaranteed, I can tell you that much.
Yep, these guys are guaranteed not to rust, wrinkle, bust, pick up dust, arc, spark, glow in the dark, or get ate up by an aardvark. The Shotgun Red doll never needs winding, never needs batteries, never needs ironing, guaranteed to catch fish or almost half your money back. Be a big hit at parties, impress your friends, be the first one you're blocking.
Off the microphone. Why are you pulling back up off there?
Our show is the only show in Nashville, Tennessee that comes with a money-back guarantee. We guarantee you ain't getting no money back.
Thanks a lot. You've been a lot of fun. God bless you. Bye-bye now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Hall, Shotgun Red, and the Shotgun Red Band. We are doing something extremely special this week. 10% of the proceeds from all the Shotgun Red gift items that you purchase today is going to go to help send 7 starving and deprived musicians to the Bahamas next year. Thank you very much for sticking around for our show. God bless each and every one of you, and thanks for joining us on the grandest showboat of them all, the General Jackson. Thank you.
Still I wonder, this time did it feel like thunder?